I realized that what I loved most and what people came to me for was what I called productivity. It was people wanting to figure out how to make themselves do stuff that they didn't want to do. I can't make you do what you don't want to do, but I can help you look at it in new ways so that you might want to. I can help you let go of stuff that somebody else is trying to make you think you need to do, but you really don't want to. I mean, it's not important for you. It might be important for your mother. What I have come to realize is that productivity is about feeling good about yourself and what you're doing. That's my definition of being productive, is I feel like I'm getting what I want done, I'm reaching my goals, I'm on path, I'm moving forward with what's important to me, and it's consistent. I call it a sustained sense of accomplishment. So it's not just, I would manage to get this one thing done and now I'm going to be resistant and procrastinate on everything
Right.
else. It's a flow. And it's also not one size fits all. Everybody has their own style of how they're going to get stuff done, how they're going to turn their focus and get themselves geared up to do what it takes. And some people are going to do things 24 hours a day. They're going to use every little 5 minutes effectively, and they're going to just be checking stuff off all day long,
Right.
and go to sleep and wake up and just do the
The
and
organized lists and
yes,
everything. Yeah.
but for most of us, it doesn't work that way. And so what I love to do is help people find their own groove. I call it productive life. It's a life where you feel like you're doing what you want to do and feeling great about yourself.
That's great. Do you use your You said you had your master's in the organizational stuff.
I definitely use it in terms of time frame and chunking
Right.
things out and breaking processes down into steps.
Yep.
Doable steps. One of the things in the Designing Your Life material they talk about is set the bar low and clear it. And so finding out what am I willing to do? What can I say I will accomplish today at the very lowest
Right.
level and doing it and then giving yourself a gold star because you did it. And then you begin to build a history of things that you have accomplished and that
Right.
you
Of
commit to
success.
and follow through on. So
Right.
yeah, getting your sense of commitment to yourself back again.
When we're productive, quote unquote, productive, it feels so good. It's so rewarding. So how to tap into that feeling, right, to prompt you to get things done. I mean, you get this immediate feedback. So yeah.
Yeah, and I call myself a recovering procrastinator, and I can be, I have been very good at not doing stuff. I can resist it. I can you can say, you know, Liz, you really want to do this, and I can be a rock, but I find myself if like I did nothing over a weekend. If days have passed and there's just not I don't have anything to show for it, I feel awful. So I have learned at my advanced age that I really do need to accomplish something, my own version of something. It's not going to look like my friends list.
Yeah. I mean, I know myself, if I go days and days not getting things done, then I feel terrible. Yeah. And
Yeah.
it's the opposite of energizing. If you
Yeah,
don't, you're just like,
yeah.
and it gets worse and worse. But then when I do have a productive stretch, then allowing just a day of quiet feels like a
Oh.
productive thing. You know what I mean? It's sort of like
Yeah.
when it's intentional, right?
Well, I agree, and I think that it's learning to trust yourself, to know that hey, I'm tired. I want to take a nap right now. I know I have a list of things to do, but if I give myself what I want, then I will be refreshed and more able to do that. If I force myself, no, you have to do the horrible thing now, even though you're tired, then I'll, my resistance will kick in. And but it's and some of us who have struggled with as procrastinators, we don't believe that we're going to get back to it. We don't trust ourselves. And I think when we can tap into our own intrinsic motivation by doing what we want to do and knowing that that's the right thing to do. I have a favorite story. My sister told me a story one time that she was dieting. She had weight struggles, and she wanted a spoonful of Hershey syrup. She had a Hershey syrup in the refrigerator, and she wanted a spoonful of it. And she said, no, I'm dieting. I won't have a spoonful of Hershey syrup. I'll have carrot sticks." And okay, that didn't quite satisfy her. And I'll have celery too. And I'll have a peanut butter sandwich. I'll have another peanut butter sandwich. God damn it, I'm going to eat that whole jar or the whole can of Hershey syrup. And it was because she didn't give herself what she wanted in that first moment that everything spiraled out of control.
Oh my gosh, I so understand that. Yeah, that feeling of it's like coming at things in a negative way, right? Like with if we come at things with, self-judgment and a feeling of like I have to deprive myself of something good because I have to do this or get this done,
And
then
you're wrong. You're wrong for wanting it.
It's like bullying ourselves, right?
Exactly.
Which just is not a healthy or sustainable way to
No.
go about being
No.
productive in the world
That's
or losing weight or anything.
yeah. So that's what I love doing is helping people give themselves permission to be themselves and to do productivity their own way.